Hey everyone and welcome. Today I'm coming at you from Oregon Pipe National Monument. I'm going to be hiking a short loop trail, about 1.2 mile loop trail called the Desert View Trail. It's supposed to cut through a section of the park that's very dense with the Oregon Pipe cacti that make this region famous. So I've come to seek them out. If you want to see if I can find them, stick around. So this sign is giving you a little bit of information of interest really here is that please allow for an hour for a leisurely walk. About 1.2 miles, even though the sign up front said 1.5 miles. The map book says 1.2, so I'm going with that. All right, and here we go. We're starting the official Desert View Trail. So you can see it's a pretty rocky trail so far. I don't think we're gonna be dealing with any major elevation today. Should be a relatively easy one, and already off the bat, look at that. Oregon Pipe cacti, as far as the eye can see. Just a few feet in, and look at that. So there's a good reason why I think we're seeing them all of a sudden. We've kind of come up out of the parking lot, down that hill over there, and I was at the visitor center earlier, and the ranger told me that these things love to live up on the hillside because it's warmer, and they don't do well with frost. Frost can kill them. So, the further uphill you go, the more we should see, which is why I assume we're seeing such a dense collection already off the bat. So far, this trail does not disappoint and lives up to the hype. This place has got Oregon Pipe cacti everywhere. So did you know that this is the only place in the United States you can come to see the Oregon Pipe? They protected virtually all the land where these things are, and there's nowhere else where you can see this. Now, these are pretty common in Mexico the further south you go, but here in the US is what I'm talking about. You're not gonna be seeing this up in Phoenix or Tucson. You have to come down here. All along the trail is a lot of really nice educational signage about the flora and fauna here in the desert. They're very short. They're also in Spanish too, so it doesn't take much time to stop and read. I decided to come out here pretty late afternoon. It's after 4 o'clock. The sign said this trail should only take an hour, so I should be done well before sunset. The sun's still pretty high in the sky right now. It is starting to cool off pretty quickly. It was hot earlier. Here in the Sonoran Desert, things cool off fast, so just be prepared for that if you ever come to visit. Maybe bring a hoodie in your backpack, just in case. Outside of seeing these awesome Oregon Pipe cacti up here, this is a really fine specimen of the Sonoran Desert. You've got some wildflowers this time of the year, all sorts of cacti. You got cholla, saguaro, in addition to the Oregon Pipe, so very beautiful landscape out here. Very stunning. You don't really see too many dense pockets of wildflowers out here. They're definitely in bloom, but they're more like smaller pockets like this. But they are pretty when you see them. So far, what the ranger told me at the visitor center is definitely true. I am seeing the densest concentration of these Oregon Pipe cacti here in this section compared to anywhere else I've been yet. I don't know if this is the best place in the entire park, but he did say this is a good place to go, and it's very casual. At a mile long, I think most people can do this one. Let's get an up-close look here at one of these. You can see they're covered in spines, so you don't want to be touching that. They are beautiful though, aren't they? This trail is nice and quiet too. Very, very few people out here. I have not seen anybody out on the trail. A couple people hanging about the parking lot. So if you're looking for a nice secluded walk, this seems to be a good one. Now if you look down there, I've already kind of come probably halfway down the loop, I'm guessing. I can see a bathroom down there. That's a group campground and bathroom where the trailhead is. So I think we're winding down around this way, and we're gonna come back out on the other side of the bathroom from where we started. And the mountains around here are also amazing, especially at this time of day. I love when the shadows start to get longer out here in the desert. Such a beautiful place. I suspect these are baby ones. I'm guessing they're probably already pretty old. I don't know how fast these grow. I didn't see any information about that yet, but yeah, I'm guessing those are junior Oregon pipe cacti. These things really get big too. Like, that's a big one right there. You can see a thicker gathering of these yellow blooming flowers down here in this wash. Yeah, and virtually no Oregon pipe here in this general vicinity down in this wash. They're very particular about where they live, apparently. It's really pretty here in this wash. You got a lot of this white rock. I don't know if that's granite or not, but it's very reminiscent of the White Tank Mountains that we visited recently. I haven't seen any of these yet. These other, I forget what they're called. Are they fairy dusters, I think? They're really pretty. So if you see some of our other videos, I like to point these out. These are ocotillo, the things with the little tentacles here. They're really starting to get their green leaves right now. And up tip top there, you can't really see with the sun, starting to get their orange flowers. Really pretty. We have a couple of those in our yard in Phoenix. We're starting to head back uphill now, and it should be no surprise, starting to see more of the Oregon pipes poking their little heads up. Sun is very close to going down behind that hill there, and it is cooling off fast. It's very pretty seeing the last rays of sunlight coming from behind that hill. But of course, the further out you look, you can tell not a ways to go till sunset. But in this immediate vicinity, the shadows are almost completely here. And other than the wind, it is pristine out here. In terms of the noise, it's quiet. I can't hear any of the human sounds. I can't hear the cars driving by on Highway 85 out there. I'm far enough away from all that noise pollution. All I hear are a few crickets and a gentle breeze. All right, we are really scaling this hill now, which is a good thing because I think we'll be able to see more Oregon pipes the higher up we go. And sure enough, look at that. Now for a reference point, you see that building in the center of the frame? That is the restroom facility near where the trailhead is. If you drew a line from the other side of that building straight to where the desert starts past the parking lot, that's where we started our trail. I'm going to zoom out now and show you how far we've come. I'm wondering if I'm nearing the pinnacle of the climb here. Hasn't been too bad at all. Here's another really good view of how far up we came if you use the bathroom down there as the reference point. Not bad. That feels good. The sun. It's kind of breezy here this late afternoon and chilly down in the shade. Very windy at the top of the hill though. I love how the sun just glows in these cholla at this time of the day. They just really light up. All right, I'm gonna guess that we've come to the height of the ascent. It's a really sharp turn here. Looks like it's gonna start curving back down towards where we started, but I'm gonna just take one last look up this hill here because that is a beautiful collection of Oregon pipe right there. Oh yeah, this is taking us right through Oregon pipe cacti country. They're everywhere up here. I would say my favorite part of the hike so far is climbing that hill and getting to the top, and then kind of getting all the views you get. You get to see a lot of the Oregon pipe cacti up here. This seems to be the best part. And then the views, of course, facing out towards Mexico land. There's a good bird's eye view of the Twin Peaks campground where I'm camping tonight. You can really see the shadows starting to creep up the hill there. When I started, that was all bathed in sunlight. All right, we're starting to go back down again, down this hill, and just as expected, all of a sudden you just stop seeing these things. And it's pretty abrupt. I mean, you can see they're all over the place right around here. And then all of a sudden, almost nada. I mean, I see a random one or two here and there, but really, for all intents and purposes, virtually none. One quick note I wanted to make to you is if you visit here at Oregon Pipe or some other parks across Arizona, they're doing a little promotion, like hiking for health kind of thing, where here at this park, if you walk 5 miles, you get this nifty little pin. I actually earned one from Chiricahua National Monument not that long ago, and I'll put a link in the description below to that video to show you how it works. But this is the second trail I've hiked today. So far I'm over halfway to the 5 miles required to get the pin. So tomorrow before I leave, I will have earned it and I will claim it. And we're not far. That parking lot right below there is where our destination is. Although that'll be the end of this video, I still have to walk to the other side of the campground to get to my site. So I have a little ways to go, but you guys are almost done. So overall, this was a beautiful hike. It was really easy, just a little bit more than a mile, as we've already said. And I do want to give kudos to the ranger who told me about this, because once again, he said this is a great place to see a large concentration of the Oregon pipe cacti. And you do, I think mainly on that hillside over there. And you'll see them on that hillside also, more from a distance, but you'll get really up close to many of them. So in that regard, if you've come down here to see Oregon pipes, this is where you want to go. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Also, find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. See you next time.